All right. Well, if you have your Bibles, let's go ahead and open them up to Philippians. Philippians chapter 4. We're looking at verses 6 through 7. And we're talking about the greatest verses in the Bible this week in reference to fear, worry, and anxiety. And, you know, I know that none of us struggle with fear, worry, or anxiety, right? You know, not one of us, not a day in our lives. Certainly we do. And whether you know it or not, these are the three main tools of the enemy. You know, often we, like Paul had to tell the Ephesians, he says, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age. Like, you might think your problem are people problems, your problem is at work or with your finances or some addiction in your life. And I'm not saying the enemy isn't using those things. But the truth behind it, according to God's word, is there are spiritual powers at work in this world that are against the work of Jesus in your life. And the three things they use the most are fear, worry, and anxiety. And here in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 through 7, this certainly is the poster verse for fear, worry, and anxiety. This is the one that I know I said it earlier in our devotional series here on this, but I would recommend you memorize this one as well. Put it to memory, maybe take a picture of it in your Bible and look at it today and just recite it to yourself. That's what the word meditate means. It doesn't mean you touch your fingers and you hum. The Bible speaks of meditation as speaking truth over your life and really chewing on it, like nature, we see the cow chews the cud. It'll chew it, and then it'll drop it down into one of its stomachs and pop it back up to chew it again, get a little bit more nutrients out of it. And we need to do that with God's word. And here in Philippians 4, Paul is writing this letter from a prison cell, right? And the whole epistle here, the whole letter is about joy. It teaches us that our circumstances have nothing to do with whether or not we'll have joy. It's really our connection to the Lord. And Paul says, Philippians 4, verse 6, be anxious for some things. Nope, not what it says. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything. So if you're going to be anxious for nothing, you can't, thank God Paul didn't just say be anxious for nothing, period, and then end the book, because we'd go, what? How's that possible? Can anyone do this? I can't do this. Can you do this? I can't do this. You know, how can we be anxious for nothing? He says, but in everything, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. So what does Paul say here? He says, be anxious for nothing, not period, but, so how do you do this? In everything. So that means not just at church, right? Not just before we're about to eat a big meal and we're going to pray and bless the food, right? Not just in the morning when we wake up, but in everything. Throughout the day, Paul would say to the Thessalonian church, he says, pray without ceasing. You know, some of us think of prayer like you hold your hands like this, you bow your head like this, you close your eyes, you get a funny voice, right? That's not what prayer, I mean, it can be prayer, I guess, but that's not what God envisions prayer to be. Prayer is simply talking to God, right? A relationship with God is not a monologue, it's a dialogue, meaning we talk to God through prayer, he talks to us through his word, right? And that should be going on throughout the day. That should be continuously happening. And that's what Paul's saying here. In everything, by prayer, supplication, and thanksgiving. Prayer is just talking to God. Supplication is asking God for provision. It's praying for God, the supply of his spirit. Supplication, supply. It's okay. Some of us say, no, the Lord's got enough problems. I'm not going to ask him for my needs. And God said, no, you ask me. And with thanksgiving, thank him in advance. You know, some of these things we need to say, Lord, I thank you in advance for what you're going to do in this area. I believe you. I believe you. Your word says if I ask anything according to your will, you know, in Jesus' name, it'll be answered. And I believe you. You know, one drop of Jesus' blood on a prayer request, man, it's a big deal. I think Charles Spurgeon said that. Big deal. But he says, and verse 7, and the peace of God. When you do this, the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. You know, so as you refuse to say, you know, anxiety hits you in the morning, fear hits you in the morning, and you say, you know what, Lord, I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to trust you with this today. I'm going to believe you through prayer and supplication with thanksgiving. I'm going to trust you. The peace of God comes and rests on you. Doesn't mean the situation is healed. You know, God doesn't go hocus pocus and then everything changes. But what happens is you change. And as he changes you and infuses you into the situation, guess what happens? The situation begins to change. Christ in you. So be anxious for nothing today, but in everything by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. And Father, I pray for my brothers and sisters today that you would encourage them in these things. Lord, they would be anxious for nothing. They would pray without ceasing, and they would experience your peace continually today. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Amen.